Hello, God bless you. Hope everyone is having a great day. This is Brother David. Want to bring out a beautiful scripture. We are in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 22, which says, "For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive." Isn't that beautiful? The two alls in this verse are alike only in the sense that they both apply to descendants, because everyone who's ever lived on this earth has descended from Adam. And because of Adam's sin, all are born with a sinful nature and all die. But the second all only applies to believers, those who have accepted Jesus' free gift, to come to the same knowledge of Jesus Christ. By Adam, sin entered the world, and death in payment for that sin also entered. Jesus Christ is the tree of life. Those who have partaken of Jesus have partaken of this life, and that means those who have accepted Jesus as their Lord and Savior. They've partaken in this life that Jesus offers. We are no longer dead to sin, but alive in the Lord Jesus Christ. Adam's sin introduced death into the world. Death and sin became the pattern for all who would follow and descend from Adam. Because all are born into Adam's sin. And because Adam sinned, all sin. Because Adam died, all die. In a similar way, Jesus' resurrection from the dead became the pattern for all who have put their faith and trust in Jesus, who are forgiven for their sin through faith in Jesus. And because he was the resurrection in bodily form, so all who are in Jesus will also be physically resurrected. Adam's failure to obey God brought sin into the world. Sin was responsible for death. As people, we have all the same tendency to sin. Everyone has sinned, therefore all will die. We cannot avoid death. But Jesus came into the world to rescue us from sin and sin's result. Christ Jesus gives life, and we could choose to share in Jesus' life or not. And if we belong to Jesus, we have God's gift of eternal life. And this life begins on this earth and continues beyond physical death. So if you haven't chosen today to put your faith and trust in Jesus, maybe you intellectually know who he is, maybe you know what he did on the cross, but you don't know him personally. You never take the time to talk to him, to get to know him, to pray to him, to read the Bible. I want to introduce you to Jesus. I want you to understand that right now your inheritance of the offense of Adam is not God's plan for you. That inheritance leads to destruction. But in Christ all shall be made alive. You'll have an inheritance of eternal life, which is peace. So we want to share the gospel, to introduce you to who Jesus is, to explain what that sacrifice means to you. Because of the fall from Genesis chapter 3, in Adam all die. Sin entered the world. Sin creates a wall that separates all of us from God. Romans 3:23 confirms this sin, that all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. That's New Testament. That means that whether you're a believer or not, all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Romans 6:23, also New Testament, says the wages of sin is death, meaning because of our sin, not one of us is worthy of going to heaven. There is a punishment for sin. Because of our sin, we all deserve punishment. We are all destined to destruction because we are all in Adam and all die. We are all descendants of Adam. But here's the thing, Christ shall all be made alive. As we see in John 3:16, God loves you so much that Jesus left heaven, became a flesh and blood human, fully God, fully man. 2 Corinthians 5:21 tells us that Jesus lived a perfect sinless life. But on the cross, Jesus became sin for us to pay our sin. Meaning when Jesus was on the cross, Jesus put our sins on himself. Jesus took the punishment for our sin, took our punishment in our place, the punishment we deserve. And when we believe the gospel message and are saved, then we put on Jesus' righteousness. Because we, like a garment, are stained with sin, And when we accept Jesus as our Lord and Savior, we are washed clean with the precious blood of Jesus, washed white as snow. And now when God looks at us, he doesn't see our sin. Now God sees Jesus. The gospel message is 1 Corinthians 15, 1 through 4. Jesus died for our sins, was buried, and rose again from the dead on the third day, according to the scriptures. Romans 10, 9 says, if you confess Jesus with your mouth and believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, then you'll be saved. And as we see at the end of John 3, 16, whoever believes in Jesus will have eternal life. Because as we said, everyone is descended from Adam. They all inherit his sinful nature and will all die. But only those who accept Jesus. It's not everybody. But only those who accept Jesus as their Lord and Savior will be made alive, and they will have eternal life. Romans 10:13 says it like this, for whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Those will be the ones that in Christ will be made alive. Not everybody, just those who accept Jesus. Because Jesus tells us in John 14:6, he is the way, the truth, the life. He is the only way to get to heaven. He's the only way to get to the Father. There are not multiple ways to be saved, not multiple ways to get to heaven. No one else can save you. A preacher cannot save you. Your mama, your daddy, they cannot save you. Your works, your deeds, they cannot save you. Salvation cannot be found anywhere else and in anyone else. Salvation can only be obtained by Jesus, because Jesus' blood is our ticket. Jesus on the cross paid the price for our sins, took our punishment. Jesus' blood is what bought our ticket into heaven. Jesus' blood is what covered our sin debt, past, present, and future. Jesus' blood is what broke down that wall that separates us from God. So if you sincerely believe and surrender your life to Jesus, meaning you're not just saying words to try to please someone because someone made you feel guilty to walk down that aisle or whatever it may be, and you're not looking for a get-out-of-hell-free card, but you really believe in what Jesus did for you on the cross and you truly want to live for him now, then you'll be saved. And this is Jesus' free gift to you. And all you have to do is accept it. And when you're in Christ, you'll be made alive. Because we cannot earn our way to heaven. We cannot be a good enough person, enough good deeds. And when you stand before God, if you haven't accepted Jesus, then it will not matter how much you've given to charity or that you think that you're a good person, that you've never robbed or killed anybody. Our works, our deeds are not good enough to get us into heaven. We have to accept Jesus. Ephesians 2, 8, 9 says, it's by grace that we are saved through faith. It is not of ourselves, it's a gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. Meaning we cannot earn our way to heaven. We don't even deserve to go to heaven, but God loves us enough that he made a way. He sent Jesus, and when we are in Jesus, we'll be made alive. And we always follow the gospel with the wording of Jesus as in return, because right now you can personally know who Jesus is. But one day soon, and how soon, we don't know. But complete hell on earth will come. We can see it coming. The world is getting darker by the minute. The Bible predicts it. The shadow of the tribulation is so big right now, we can barely see light around it. And one day soon, the restrainer who is holding all hell back will be removed. Then the tribulation will begin, and it will be a time of terrifying supernatural events, scarier than any movie you've ever seen or nightmare you ever had. Each day will get progressively worse. It'll be literal hell on earth. It is coming. Bible prophecy is jumping off the page. And if you paid attention to what happened last night, Bible prophecy definitely jump off the page. And I want you to know Jesus personally before all hell breaks loose, because right now, before the tribulation starts, we are under the age of grace, meaning that right now is the easy way out. To come to Jesus, all you have to do is sincerely believe in what Jesus did for you on the cross and surrender your life to him. Accept Jesus' free gift, that free ticket into heaven. But after the tribulation begins, the age of grace will be over, and then it'll be the hard way, and you have to do more than just believe in Jesus. You will have to die for Jesus. But I love you, and I don't want that for you. So right now, before the age of grace is over, please turn to Jesus today. Because one thing is for sure, the Bible is clear. We are not guaranteed tomorrow. We are not guaranteed our next breath. And even if we are here to see some of the hell that's coming, who knows how long we'll be able to survive. But the point is that the end is here. You don't have the time to keep putting Jesus off. So if you don't know Jesus personally, please take the time to get to know him today while you still have the time. So whatever excuse you may be telling yourself right now, do not put Jesus off any longer. We are not guaranteed our next breath. There's no guarantee you will live to see tomorrow. Today is the day of salvation. So if you would like to be saved, we have in the description box a link to the ABCs of Salvation and a sample prayer. But these are just templates and outline of what you can say to be saved. It is not a repeat after me. There are no magic words to be saved. In fact, these words are not even important. But if you want to be saved, it just needs to be a sincere prayer from your heart that you can't do this on your own, that you need a Savior. Well, I pray you got something out of this, but do not take my word for it. Because no one on this earth has the answers you're looking for. Whether it's the most famous preacher or the smartest person in the world, they do not have the answers. Only God does, and you only receive your answers through prayer and by reading the Bible. And it's so very important to read the Bible for yourself. Just picking random verses or listening to someone read or preach for a few minutes, you won't get the full picture. They can't even scratch the surface of what is in the Bible. So read and discover the stories for yourself. And the Bible will strengthen you and help you to face any and every trial, tribulation, temptation, or struggle that you may be going through right now. In the description box, we have several sources to help you to read the Bible. And if you need prayer today, please reach out to us. We want to stand in agreement and pray for your needs. Or if you have a praise report, please reach out to us. We want to praise Jesus right along with you for what he's doing in your life. Well, I pray that you got something out of the video today. If you did, give God glory. I cannot wait to see what the Lord has for us tomorrow. I love you. Jesus loves you. God bless you. I hope you have a great day. We'll see you tomorrow if the Lord tarries, or see you in the clouds.